A new report in the New York Times describing how political operatives exploited stories of sexual misconduct for the purpose of political gain. And these explosive new claims will leave Americans of all political stripes questioning the integrity of the entire Me Too movement, not to mention the victims of these horrific allegations. Now left wondering, did anyone really care about their cries for help? The New York Times piece citing Washington lawyer Deborah Katz, who says, quote, "There is a danger in this environment that unsophisticated individuals who have been abused by powerful people could be exploited by groups seeking partisan advantage or by lawyers seeking a moment in the limelight." One of the political operatives whose name is at the center of the story, David Brock, the founder of Media Matters, who famously declared war on Fox News and launched a campaign to dig up dirt on the people who work here, both on camera and off. According to the Times, Brock and his fellow operatives are at it again, funneling hundreds of thousands of dollars to women's rights attorney Lisa Bloom, who in turn pushed more female victims into the spotlight to accuse Donald Trump of sexual assault. Here now is the man behind the expose, New York Times reporter Kenneth Vogel. Kenneth, first walk us through your reporting on this and what you learned.
Yeah, we found, Sandra, that in the week before the election, there had been a press conference that Lisa Bloom scheduled at which she was promising that a woman would come forward and detail explosive allegations against Donald Trump. When that fell through, she says that a number of major Democratic donors reached out to her and offered help, financial help we're talking about, to see what they could do to bring this woman back to the table, get her to go public with her allegations. She did not come forward. Lisa Bloom said she wouldn't come forward, but Lisa Bloom told these donors that she had several other women with whom she was working who also had allegations against Donald Trump who might be convinced to come forward if there was funding provided, she said, for their safety, possibly even a safe house, relocation services. Several of these donors did end up writing checks, at least $700,000 we found, including $200,000 from a group associated with David Brock, $500,000 from Susie Tompkins Buell. This is a major donor in San Francisco who co-founded the Esprit clothing line, who is very close to Hillary Clinton. They provided this money. Ultimately, those women with whom Lisa Bloom was working did not come forward, and she refunded some, but not all of the money.
Now, Ken, I know in your reporting you follow the money trail. Were you able to determine exactly how much money was used to go after these victims for political gain?
No, we weren't. There's no real disclosure on this. In fact, interestingly, David Brock's group that wrote this $200,000 check to Lisa Bloom's law firm, a group called American Bridge 21st Century, recently filed its tax return, public tax return for 2016. It did not include this $200,000 payment in there. I'm not exactly sure why. There may be some legal reasons why it was able to avoid disclosing that, but it just goes to show how difficult this money can be to be traced because it's money being paid to either private individuals or to law firms in this case that have no disclosure requirements. So we don't know how much of this is going on. We did find out, though, in our reporting, Sandra, that in fact Lisa Bloom's mother, another well-known women's rights attorney, Gloria Allred, who has brought her fair share of sexual harassment allegations, is currently raising money for another lawsuit against Donald Trump, a defamation lawsuit by a woman who was on The Apprentice who accused Donald Trump of sexually harassing her. So that's yet another example we found of an effort to raise money to bring forward and support
examples
these types of allegations.
In your reporting, Ken, examples of the left going after the right using these victims. But this is something that your reporting also reveals a scene on the right as well.
Yeah, that's right. Mike Cernovich, the well-known Trump backer who has a big and sort of controversial social media presence, offered publicly $10,000 for any woman who came forward with details of or actual documents showing a settlement by a member of Congress. He did not specify a Democratic member of Congress, a member of Congress who had settled sexual harassment claims. In fact, he did end up getting the sexual harassment settlement that ended up bringing down John Conyers, Representative John Conyers, Democrat from Michigan, until then the longest serving member Democrat in the House of Representatives. And Cernovich told me that he was surprised. He actually offered the person who brought him that confidential settlement money in exchange for it, and the person turned it down.
Right.
So just because money is being offered, Sandra, it doesn't necessarily mean that people who are coming forward.
It's an excellent point. And something else that stood out to me in your reporting, Ken, is the title of your piece in the New York Times itself, "Partisans Wielding Money Begin Seeking to Exploit Harassment Claims." Do you think that we're just at the beginning of this?
I think we could be, Sandra. Certainly, David Brock has already promised that he will start a fund explicitly to try to bring forward allegations against Republican politicians. So he is saying he wants to do more of this, despite the backlash that he has gotten, the controversy around his efforts with Lisa Bloom in the run-up to the 2016 presidential election.
All right, Ken Vogel, thank you for your reporting on that.